everybody wants to know.
Why are we crying?
Why were we crying? Someone said, are y'all dating anyone? Be real.
Do you guys find yourself in a situation where you're, you know, going after the same guy?
He does.
You're literally describing my ex.
Her ex. How do we handle decorating, payments, all that stuff? Hello, YouTube. Welcome back to my channel. It is Jeanine Amapola. This is your first time seeing my face. And this is my roommate, Madison Pruitt.
Madi Pruitt in the house.
So y'all might know her from
The Bachelor.
The Bachelor. And I'm a YouTuber and Instagrammer, or whatever you want to call it. So as you guys have seen, or might have seen on our Instagrams, we moved to Dallas 2 months ago, and I bought a house, we've been living in it, we're still working on it, and it has been so much fun.
So fun.
But we consistently get questions on both of our Instagrams about like us, what we're doing, our beliefs, dating.
Why we are living together.
Why did we live together?
Dallas,
how did we meet each other? Everything. So today we're going to be doing a Q&A on my channel, and Madi actually is now a YouTuber.
Woo-hoo!
I'm super excited.
New and fresh. She's teaching me all the things.
I kind of am, but you're also been teaching me some other things as well. So it's been great. But on Maddie's channel, we're going to be doing Instagram controls our day. So make sure you guys go check that out on her YouTube channel linked down below. And let's just get into it, because I feel like this video is going to be kind of long because y'all got some good questions for us.
Yes.
And we got some good answers.
Come on.
Hopefully. If this is your first time to my channel, subscribe down below and also check out Maddie's channel. And I'm nervous. Okay. Wow. Okay. What do we want to start on?
You want to start off on a bang? Oh, maybe we start with us.
How did y'all meet?
How did we meet? Question mark, question mark, question mark.
Yes. So basically the story is we had a ton of friends in common. Madi was looking to move somewhere out of Alabama. I was looking for a roommate.
But we did have a lot of mutual friends.
A ton. Because she went to Auburn. I had a ton of friends that went to Auburn as well. They were like, Maddie's looking for a roommate. I was like, I'm looking for a roommate. And so she was supposed to move to LA with me last year.
We had this whole thing planned out. We met up. We were like, we're going to live in Santa Monica together. It's going to be so amazing.
Yep. We had everything. I had been looking at houses, apartments there, trying to find this awesome dope spot for us.
And she was dead set. Like, she was like, we're staying in Santa Monica. And I went out there for 2 weeks. And I just did not feel good about it. I was like, this is not where I'm supposed to be. And I started stressing because I was like, I really want to live with Jay.
Yep.
But I don't, I call her Jay. Yep. I really want to live with Jeanine. I was like, but I don't want to like live here. This is just not where I'm supposed to be.
And
then,
so, the pandemic hit.
Then the pandemic hit. And like,
made everything, all of our plans.
We couldn't find any house. Like, it was like a struggle.
It was
we could not find anywhere to live.
Which was the Lord being like, you're not supposed to be here.
So I started like trying to like pick her brains at some. I was like, what about like OC? Like, what about Newport?
Yeah,
like,
what about Nashville maybe?
Nashville, yeah, like some other,
other spots.
And she was like, no.
I was like,
I'm staying in Santa Monica.
I was like, I'm not leaving California. Like, I'm staying here for another year. And you were like, well, I'm not moving to California then.
Yeah.
And I was like, what am I gonna do? I started freaking out because I had basically banked on living with Madi and I had no other choices, maybe besides one other girl, but she ended up deciding to move somewhere else. And so I was like, I'm screwed.
Yeah.
So then the Lord started putting Dallas on her heart, even though you had never really been here.
No, I had been here like, I think twice and like for a very short amount of time. Like, not like I was like here for like a month. I came out here, one of my friends were out here and stayed out here and yeah. But it just like was put on my heart and my parents started being like, what about Dallas? And I was like, huh. What about Dallas?
What about Dallas?
What about Dallas?
And Madi was like, I might want to move to Texas. And I'm like, really? Magically, the Lord told me in September to move back to Dallas. And I called Madi and I said, Madi, I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to move back to Dallas. And she was like, yes, like,
I
freaked out.
I was like, oh my gosh, yes, I'm in. Like, we're doing it. Yeah. I didn't even hesitate. I was like, yes, I'm there. Like,
yeah. But we had already met back in California back in August, I think.
Yeah.
Met for the first time, and I was like, this girl is dope. And honestly, you were not like the TV show.
Really?
At all. No.
Wait, like the TV show or like how I was pictured?
How you were pictured was not what I got, and I was actually really happy. Like, I genuinely, and this was also another question someone asked us, like, what was our first impressions of living or when we met each other?
Yeah.
I literally thought Madi was gonna be super timid and quiet and reserved. And I was like, oh my God, and I'm like, no, this girl is bold. She's fearless. She says what's on her mind.
It's so funny because yeah, obviously like on a show, any show, not just The Bachelor, like there's only so much that can, it's a 2-hour episode. when they're getting hours and hours and hours and hours of footage.
Right.
And so not everything can be shown. So everyone was like, oh, Maddie's like sweet, like sweet little Alabama girl. And I was like,
I kind of thought that was what you were gonna be like. I was like, oh,
I was like, wow, I've never been called like sweet little Alabama girl. I've always been just like,
you are
stubborn,
sweet, but
fighter.
You're an eight on the Enneagram.
Yeah, I'm an eight on
She's
the
She's a challenger.
I'm a challenger. I'm like, let's do it. Let's do it now. Let's do it right. Let's win. Let's be the best. Like, let's get better. You know, I'm just like very like,
yeah.
So yeah, you're probably not expecting that. I feel like a lot of people say that.
I was like, dang, this girl is opinionated, but like she stands up for what she believes and that's what she gets what she wants also.
Yeah.
Quick thing is, what are Enneagram numbers? I'm a two wing three.
I'm a set of three wing two, and I'm like, that's not true. I'm an eight wing seven. I'm a challenger.
She is. Okay, so like, how do we handle the house? Decorating, payments, all that stuff. Who pays for what?
Well, we still are figuring out rent.
But
we pretty much, we split all bills just straight down the middle.
I basically buy the furniture because it is my house and I'm going to be living here long term, and we don't know where Maddie's going to be in the next year or 2 years. So I buy the main stuff. Maddie has definitely contributed. Like, she got the stuff for a coffee table. She's gotten like other cute decor. She took care of her bedroom. She also got some like awesome patio furniture for us. But for the most part, I do buy everything because it is my house.
Yeah.
And yeah, we sometimes just take turns on like, okay, I bought paper towels this time, you buy them next time.
Yeah.
Same thing with everything.
We
else.
Just try to be like super open with each other. Yeah.
Very open. Yeah. You have to, y'all, communication is make everything. Or break. It's everything. Yeah.
So someone asked us, how do y'all manage being a Christian in the public eye? I think it's an amazing question, and probably one of the biggest questions that I've been asked. You probably get asked that a lot too. And I know when I came off the show, like one of the biggest questions people asked me was like, how were you able to stay true to yourself and like stand firm in your convictions and not be just like fall into pressure or fall into like what everybody else is doing. And I would say one of the biggest things for us, and one of the biggest things in general when it comes to standing true to what you believe, is like really valuing the private time and really like really valuing that alone time with God.
The secret place with the Lord and your abiding time with Him.
Right, like she can talk on that too, because yeah, I think like that time is when you're really like putting the tools in the toolbox and you're investing and you're feeding yourself. You already know what you believe, and you already know like what you've read and what you've prayed and what you've been like like clinging to. So when those moments come, it's not like you're having to like flip a switch. It's like, no, I'm just like, what's inside of me is just what's going to come out of me.
So true.
And so I would definitely say like one of the biggest things is really valuing that private life, and also knowing like why we do what we do and like the purpose behind everything. And so not getting caught up, we were talking about this last night, like not getting caught up in like, it's all about me, like all eyes are on me. It's about me. But it's like, no, my life is to like serve the Lord and to serve others. And when I live with that kind of mentality, like I think it does make it a little bit easier to like shrug off the like opinions or the haters or like the pressure of the eyes on you. So that would kind of be my answer.
Yeah, I mean, definitely second that. I have a podcast like all about this as well. I do my podcast called Happy and Healthy. I would definitely say remembering, first of all, that you have an audience of one. At the end of the day, you're holding yourself accountable to God and God alone.
Yeah.
Sure, you want to do things that are beneficial, fruitful for people, but what you do, no matter what you do, Christians are going to have something to say and non-Christians are going to have something to say. So you might as well do what you need to do for the Lord, for God, your conviction with the Lord. And if you have people around you being like, what you're doing is great, I champion you, like this is good, then keep going, because someone's always gonna have something to say. So doing it for the audience of one, for the Lord, and making sure that you're just being obedient. You know, it definitely can be hard, but like the comments, like you do have to build a thick skin, but also sometimes you just can't look at it. Like you just, sometimes I just don't read the DM or I just don't read the comment, because people just don't really know you. They don't really know the truth or the real story or what really went on. And you just have to remember that God is my defender. That's something that Maddie talked about the other day about being on the show, is like the Lord will avenge for you. He is your defender. So you don't always have to sit there and defend yourself, say something, justify yourself, always give some disclaimer. So like, let that rest, put it in His hands and just drop it and be like, you know what? I've done what I can do. And now God, like, I'm just putting this in your hands and resting in that.
Okay. So someone said, Jeanine, would you ever go on The Bachelor?
I've been asked this so much.
And would Maddie let you? No, Maddie would not let you. Madi would not let you,
Madi. Would not let me.
I would fully show up on set and just pull her off. That yeah. hair and just come get on, out of we're here. Going back home.
Yeah, I don't think I would do it. I've definitely had like my team encourage me a while ago being like, you should go on it. And I've never really been interested. Honestly, like I already get criticized enough as it is on the internet. And so to have millions of people criticizing me, can't imagine dealing with that. And I just don't foresee that being the story that God has for me. You know, it's great if it's for other people. Like it clearly worked out for Sean and Catherine Lowe and plenty others, but I just don't think that's for me. So I'm very happy with where I'm at right now in life.
I would
and
not all let that you. Stuff. You.
I know do. Way too much about all people.
She
I know.
Knows all the
I know way too much. I'm like, I can't do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't let you. And like, I mean, I didn't share my story, but my story is very much like where I, it was just where I felt like God was leading me, but
yeah.
I don't know that I could have stepped into it unless I had that peace from God and in knowing that was where he was leading me.
Yeah.
I know that I'm better and stronger from it. And like I've seen how God's used it and totally. Just how it's brought me incredible relationships and so much more. Yeah. And so for that, I'm so grateful.
And I'm really thankful that Madi went on it because obviously because of that, she's helped so many freaking women and we got to meet each other through that. So that's amazing.
So praise God
so,
for that. So
yay.
Yay!
Upon further review of footage, most of the footage was out of focus, so we're redoing a majority of this footage.
Yeah, it's pretty
but sad. It was the good meat that I know you'll want, and so yes. we're re-answering the questions.
So we're back, baby, and we're back.
We're back and better than
we're
ever.
Back and we're better than ever.
We're answering questions about dating.
Yes.
They want to know, who are we dating? Are we dating? What do we look for? Who's each other's type? Have you gone on dates? Men. So why were we crying the other day?
Why were we crying? Okay.
Where do we start? Okay, why were we crying the other day?
Okay, we'll start.
We were having a Jesus moment together. I was out of town for a long weekend. She was here alone in Dallas. We were catching up. We were just pouring into each other's hearts, hearing how everyone was doing.
It wasn't like one of those moments where we were just like sulking and we were just like, woe is me. Yeah, life is horrible. It was one of those moments where it was like, I miss you. Let's catch up. And like just reflecting on all that God's doing like yeah. in our hearts right now and in our lives right now. But then also our boy situation kind of came up.
And
there were some tears. I literally was middle of the sentence talking to Jeanine and just like poop, started boohooing.
Yeah, and then I saw her sad, and then I got sad, and then I started getting sad about my boy problem, and I was like.
Literally, we just sat there and cried for a minute, but then we were.
But also, it's good because like you need to have those moments, especially if you're living with somebody and you want to deeply know somebody. Like you need to ask each other questions.
Yeah.
You need to be like, how are you doing? And that was what that moment was.
And it was like good at just like no matter what we've been through, I think just seeing God's faithfulness through all of it, and even in the moments where it feels like a no or a closed door or a question mark, just being able to encourage each other like God has got us and God right. is faithful, and we're gonna just continue to trust that and wait for God's best for our lives.
Amen. Okay.
Pause. We didn't hit on any of the other boy questions. We gotta answer these boys. We're keeping you on your toes.
They wanted to know, how do we handle like the boys coming over,
that type of thing,
conflict, communication, just being like roommates. Like, how do we handle that?
Well, we're obsessed with each other, one, so that makes it easy. Two,
truly.
We keep Jesus the center. That also helps. Yes. But I would say, honestly, like you said, it, like communication, and I think just like honesty. Like we're just like always like
from the very start,
all the cards on the table.
We were like, we have to be open about like how we're feeling. And I honestly, like yesterday, one of the conversations we had is like I was struggling with something, and Madi was like, well, what are you struggling about? And I was like, to be honest, it's been something that like I've been struggling with since we started living together. And so like just being open communication with each other about that. And she was honestly able to encourage me and spur me on. And so being open and honest, and then just being clear about like our schedules, like, okay, I'm filming this day. When are you filming?
Right. Who's respecting coming over? Each other's like schedules and times and spaces.
Keep the common spaces clean. Obviously, if you want your room to be a pig pen, you can, but that's not really our style.
Right.
But
I'm definitely the more clean one.
Honestly, I will admit she is.
I know they more clean. She's not messy.
I throw clothes everywhere.
But she's just.
Not as clean as Madi. Yeah, I realize that for sure. But as far as like men, like we have this extra guest room and we're gonna use it as a guest room, an extra hangout room.
Yeah.
But that's kind of like if we ever get boyfriends when that time comes, like we kind of wanna have our own like room for that. But we know like no men are sleeping in our beds, no men are sleeping over like when the other person's not here, right? We decided on that.
Yeah, we were like, if I'm not here, you like if you start dating someone, like your
us being alone with a guy yes. when the other girls near is not smart.
Basically, we're trying to be really good about just holding each other accountable uh-huh. and just we're in a season of singleness, but also if we do start dating someone, like we're still pursuing purity and we're still pursuing the heart of God, and that's our like that's what we're going after.
Yeah.
And so just keeping each other like on track with that, I think is really important.
Yeah.
But yes, we, you know, we're never gonna be in a situation where we're like trying to go after the same guy. Like I know a lot of people were like, do you guys get jealous of each other? Do you guys find yourself in a situation where you're, you know, going after the same guy and the same guy's going after you? But like we are—
we have completely different types.
Yeah, but it's, but we do have to be intentional about it because we are obviously both single, but also like we're going after men who are going after the heart of Jesus and who have good character. And we're obviously both living in Dallas and we kind of both do the same things in life. But yes, we do have a little bit of a different yeah. type.
Let's get to the real tea because this is what everybody wants to know. Someone said, are y'all dating anyone? Be real. No.
No hesitation. No pause. No.
There's no one.
No. We. No. Well, you have been on some dates. And here's the thing. We actually are different in this way. I think we should talk about it. And so she has been going on some dates. I've been chilling at home. I like video her when she's going. I feel like a proud mom. I'm like, good luck, sweetie.
And then she'll unlock the door for me before like the guy drops me off so I can just enter easily. And I'm like, when I shut the door and I'm like,
oh my God. Then you like come in my room and I'm like, tell me everything.
Yeah, literally I'm like, this is what happened. No, basically my stance is with dating. Okay, first of all, we are both single. We are waiting for godly men. We are not settling. We're not worried. We're both really enjoying being single together. But obviously we want to find our partners. So my stance is I'm kind of like, okay, give people a shot. Now, however, I can't just be your random guy in my DMs, you know, that I'm going on a date with. Has to have a good reputation. Maybe have a friend in common referred by somebody. I know where he stands with the Lord. I know a little bit about him. It's not just gonna be some like random guy. So even though I'm open to taking shots with people, I also am still gonna be quite selective. And so I've been on 2 dates and I'm open to, you know, giving people a chance and just see what happens. If it doesn't work out, then it doesn't work out. But now you know.
But she's had guys be like, hey, I wanna take you out again. And she's like, let me find time in my schedule. It's like 2 months
Literally,
later, she's like, well, 2 months from now, I think I have an opening. And he's like, bro, what?
I seriously did that. This guy was like, when are you free? And I was like, let me check my calendar. And I was like, in a month. I feel so bad.
But this is where we are a little different. I don't enjoy going on a date with someone unless like I really know that I'm already very interested and attracted to them. Like, I'm attracted to their spirit, I'm attracted to their heart, I'm attracted to their face. I'm like, I like the way they, like, we're attracted to each other, okay? But I feel like that all kind of has to be there before I even go on a date.
But also what we said in the last time is that Maddie typically talks to men that don't live in Texas. So she gets to know them, they FaceTime, they call or whatever, they're chatting, and then she decides, okay, you're worth pursuing or you're not worth pursuing. I'm more dating locally because I personally don't really want to do long distance. Done that Fair. Before, don't enjoy
it's
it.
Not
so bad. I'm trying to stay more local, so yeah.
I kind of like long distance. I'm like, I get to do my thing, you get to do your thing, then we get to come together and like do our thing together, but like,
I just don't like it. It's backfired on me a couple times where like, yeah. you don't really know what they're doing.
Totally.
And that freaks me out.
There are some things that it makes it hard because you're like, what does their day-to-day look like?
Yes, you know? I don't like it. But anyway, okay. One of the other questions too that we got is describe each other's person, like their type. Like,
I did it so perfectly.
You
I'm
did!
Like, can I replicate it again?
I mean, maybe if the clip is not that blurry, we can insert it.
Again, this is just your type. So yeah. I see this dirty blonde guy who is like very toned and like he takes like working out seriously, but he's not like jacked. He's he's just toned. And he likes to adventure. He's very adventuresome. Like he likes to travel. He likes to surf. He likes to skateboard. He likes to try new things. Like Jeanine loves like being spontaneous. He's very like go with the flow, like flexible.
Yes.
I feel like Jeanine can be like very like responsible and timely, but also very like scatterbrained and all over the place. So I think he's gotta be like very good with that. Like go with the flow. Like
completely.
No honey, we're doing this, but also like, sure, like whatever, you
That's
know?
That's such a good point, yes.
And I see him doing that. I see him being like pretty athletic, but also like he can tap into a more like creative side.
Oh, I would, oh my God, I would dream for that.
Yeah.
I would dream to sing
and
with
then
me.
I say, obviously, like loves Jesus so much, has a big calling on his life because she's got a huge calling on her life.
That actually is pretty dang spot on.
Right?
Okay.
I feel like I know you well.
You do. Okay, so for Maddie, Maddie's into athletes. So he's got
no secret there.
He's probably gonna play a sport, or even if like he doesn't play pro, like he definitely played sports at least growing up. He can understand the sports lifestyle, especially since her dad is a coach of basketball. He's definitely got some special like swag to him. Like he's not your just like regular dude. Like he has swag or something really like uniquely cool about him. He has a really high calling. Maddie wants to respect the man that she's with and use his platform for the Lord. Amen. And to give back and to help people. He's probably gonna want to adopt. He probably is gonna wear some J's. He's gotta have some good style about him, and he's also really gotta be like super goofy and funny and can handle her baby voices that she does. Handle the baby
voices. Get out my baby voices.
And she does this creepy baby
voice. It's not creepy, it's cute.
He has to be able to handle that.
Okay,
has
but
to.
The truth is, she started doing it back to
me. I know, it's annoying.
Now she'll literally be like, yeah. And so it's contagious, and she secretly likes it. She just wants to say it's creepy.
I know it is, but I do it.
And you said earlier, like, he's got to be strong. Because
I was going to say, very strong and very confident, because that's what Maddie is. She wants to respect him. She wants to look up to him. She wants to him be able to handle her calling, because Maddie has a huge calling on her life. And if this man cannot handle it and champion and partner her in it and cannot lead her still, bye-bye.
Honey.
Bye-bye, honey.
Bye.
And then I think there was one more thing that I said. Oh, he likes the finer things in life.
Yes, he might. Which I literally was like, Jeanine, you're literally describing my ex.
Her ex.
I'm like, great, thank you.
But that's just what I'm basing it off of, but I still feel like that's what you typically go for.
Yeah.
Last thing we can answer is, what's your favorite thing about each other?
It's hard because there's a lot of things that I love about Jeanine. I feel like the thing that I really, really value about our friendship and about Jeanine is that, one, like, she gets me. Like, she gets me on every level, like, relationally, spiritually, like, influentially.
Career-wise,
in pretty much every dynamic. And so that's been so cool to have, like, because I have so many, like, God has blessed me with a lot of really incredible friends, but there's just not a lot of people who, like, fully understand, like, what I've walked through or, like, what I deal with on a day-to-day basis. And so it's just been such a blessing to, like, have someone who, like, fully gets it.
Yeah.
And then I would say, like, we're both kind of, like, that perfect balance of, like... like, oh, no. Really fun and crazy, but also, like...
we know when to be serious and when
to
slow down.
Yes, like, we can go deep, and, like, we love Jesus with all of our heart, and our mission is, like, how can I help? Like, how can I add value? How can I make a difference? How can I serve Jesus more?
Yeah.
And so, I would say, like, that's kind of... I mean, I guess it's not, like, one tiny character thing about you, but it's, like, that's, like... one of my favorite things and, like, why I am obsessed with this friendship, because
I know
I just, like, really, like, it's, like, such a blessing that it's, I'm like, oh my gosh, so someone great. Who understands me, someone who, like, gets where I'm coming from, but also someone I can have fun with, but also someone I can, like, be challenged by and go deep with.
Yes, I completely agree, and I love you so much.
I love you more.
But genuinely, like, us moving to Dallas has been such a blessing, because, like, I'm basically kind of starting over. I moved away 3 years ago. This is her first time here. Like, we really need each other, but, like, we do. Like, we're in the same season. We understand each other. Most of my friends are married. And so we are in the same season. And, like, it has been so great to see how we encourage each other, but also call each other out, call each other higher. And, like, we refine each other to look like Jesus. Also, without even having to say anything, just by the way we live, I look at Maddie and I'm like, okay, I'm going to go open my Bible. I'm going to go do this. I'm going to go pray for that person. I'm going to donate more money here just by watching what she does. And that's what's so beautiful. So it's a great season, and she's amazing. And she's also taught me a lot about self-worth and self-identity and valuing yourself and just who God has called you to be. So it's been amazing.
Aww.
Aww, I love her.
Roomy moment.
Okay, you guys, that is the video. Thank you guys for watching.
That was so fun.
That was so much better.
I hope you guys enjoyed it. Yeah. I think it was great.
Did you guys enjoy it? Let us know if you want more of these down the road. Maybe like an updated Q&A down the road when we might, you know,
potentially
have more updates.
And maybe our house will be done. Maybe we'll have boyfriends.
Yes.
I don't know.
We'll see. So stay tuned for that. I definitely will be doing more house updates soon. Go check out Maddie's video that she did. Her link is down below, and her Instagram. And check out my podcast and my Instagram also down below. And I'll see you guys next week.
Love you guys.
Bye. Peace out, girls.